standing ovation. I really can't read body language. You guys are amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much for the... I thank you for coming. I get the fact that my comedy can divide opinion. I get the fact that there'll be people in here who think I'm great. I also get the fact that there'll be people in here who think I'm fantastic. I get it. Don't think I don't get it. I'm very proud. This is my third tour. I'm not repeated one joke on any of the tours, which I'm very proud of. And because the worst thing... the worst thing a comedian can do is repeat himself. What was I saying? Oh yeah, the worst thing a comedian can do is repeat himself. And, I read recently that all of our jobs will soon be taken over by robots. I don't know what you think about that. I don't know. Can you picture a robot as a comedian? I can't. As long as that robot pays its taxes, we're laughing. I make some extra cash by giving surfing lessons. Don't worry, it's all above board. A man with a small penis probably needs constant reassurance. Am I right? I do have a small penis. Fortunately, my wife doesn't have a big mouth. So. She doesn't tell many people, which I appreciate. What were you thinking? Today, a midget lawyer told me that my wife wants me out of the house immediately. I thought, well, that's short notice. Any man who lives his life in accordance to a book is a fool. Luke 3:17. I'm currently reading a book about pathetic men who lie about the length of their penis. I've read 10 chapters. Hard to put down. There's a book titled Lazy Comedians Who Reinforce Negative Stereotypes that I was reading until it was stolen from me in Liverpool. It was on my tour bus. I looked for that book everywhere. I went to a bookstore in Glasgow and asked the clerk if she had the book titled Lazy Comedians Who Reinforce Negative Stereotypes. And before I could finish asking the question, she headbutted me. And deep-fried my penis. Which is why I walk this way. And then one day I was in India. Just nervously walking around. I played yesterday. Thanks, guys. When I noticed a bookstore, and in the window of the bookstore was the book I'd been looking for, the book titled Lazy Comedians Who Reinforce Negative Stereotypes. So I quickly made my way across the street, across the pavement towards the bookstore. I had my hand on the door of the bookstore. I was just about to step in when I was hit by a car driven by a woman. As I lay there writhing in pain. The horrified woman got out of her car and ran over to me and said, "That's me, John Barry! What am I like?" You've been amazing. I'm so glad we did this tonight. I hope you feel the same way. I have to shoot off. I'm a big squash player. It's a very popular sport. How many squash players are here? No one plays it. I do love squash. I've got a big match tomorrow. I played the American yesterday. Americans can be a bit competitive. part of the match, the Americans in my face saying, Francis, you're gonna go down. I'm gonna tear you a new asshole. USA, USA. Yeah. Anyway, long story short, I now have a new asshole. I love you people. Thank you so much for coming out tonight, guys. Good night. Thank you, guys.